Okay, today on this old windy day and cool 1st of April, we're going to transplant some zebra grass out here and put it in between these ponderosa pines here. So I'll need about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 clumps to get started here. First thing we'll do is dig some holes here. The dirt up down in here. About like that. They don't have to be very deep. We'll go over and after we get the holes dug here and get some clumps of zebra grass and bring over. So we'll be right back. Now I have the holes dug, about 7 of them. And there's some rocks come out of that one. A little bit rocky there. So have to go over and take a chunk out of some of the established plants on over here and bring back and drop in them holes. So we'll do that now. So here we are at a clump that's we're going to take some off of. And if the wind don't blow my camera over here.
Some of these roots can be pretty tough. Sometimes you have to use a spade or a big bar to get down through those things. They are tough. So what I'm going to do is real tough roots. Oh boy, hard to dig.
I don't know how good you can see that there, but oh, it is tough. Out your zebra grass will spread out more and more. Get bigger. Camera here and see. There you have a clump of it, and it is tough. So you can take it over to where you're going to bury it and just take little sections off of it or use the whole thing. But a 5-7 hole, I'll take it. Take more off of this clump and go on down here and take it off of some of the others. Cold, and it's supposed to be in the 20s tonight. The shoots, new shoots are coming up. I just cut this off a couple weeks ago because I let it stand all winter. And for cover. And there probably just split them clumps in two and make it go farther instead of using such a big clump. These were probably planted here, I don't know, maybe 4 or 5 years ago. Going to split. Had to split a piece of it in two. Of course, the bigger clump you put in, the more you'll have the first year. Now I'm going to split this in two again. So here's what we have. Camera sits right here. So there's what we have, a little clump there. Break up some of this sod. Get them roots covered up good. I like to tamp the dirt in there some, get the air pockets out of there.
air pockets out. And there's some new zebra grass ready to start for the year. Yep, ready to start. Then 2 or 3 years, it'll keep spreading and be a big round, pretty clump of zebra grass. So there you have it for now. Okay, now we have our zebra grass in the ground. There's one. Two. Three. Four. Five, six, and seven. And now I think I will put some mulch around all of them. I love that pile right over there. Make it look a little better, maybe. Okay, catch you later. Here, dude, just it up here a little better. Come up a little closer.
Thank you.